I'm Jeff. I use he, him, his pronouns, and my favorite place to sit, I have an L couch from IKEA that pulls out and becomes sort of a bed. But that section of the L is nice to like kind of worm your way back in there. Lounge. Maybe take a nap. All right. We are going to get things rolling this morning. Or if you're watching this in the afternoon, in the afternoon. We will need a dumbbell or kettlebell or can of soup. Something you can lift overhead with two hands. Any other equipment? Yeah, I don't think we need it. Maybe a stool, something to sit on. But don't worry about that if you don't have it. So everybody can scamper off and grab that stuff. And then we'll really get rolling. All right, we're gonna get started with our warm up. Can everybody hear me okay? All right, we're gonna get started first with inchworm press ups. So we're gonna start standing tall, can hinge forward till our hands meet the floor, walk our hands out into a plank, and then lower down. If you can lower down in a strict plank, awesome. If you need to put your knees into the floor, that's great. Lower down to the floor, press back up into that plank, and then walk your feet into your hands. So we're gonna do five of those. Inchworm press-ups. Walk your hands out into a plank, chest down to the floor, back up to a plank, walk your feet in. All right, once you've done 10 of those, we can come down to the floor. We'll get long, we'll squeeze our butt, get long through our toes, get long through our hands into an arch position, and then we're gonna rock 10 times. Then Rachel, can you hear okay?
I'm fixing it.
Okay. Then 30, jumping jacks. We're going to do 20 seconds in an extended plank. So extended plank, good morning, Amanda. Extended plank is like regular plank, but it's extended. So we're going to come into a regular plank and then put our hands out long in front of us. So we're gonna do all that three more times. 5 inchworm press ups, 10 arch rocks, 30 jumping jacks, and 20 seconds in that extended plank. Cool? Amanda, can you hear me? Great. Amanda, was that you calling about the password for Zoom? Sorry about that. Looks like everybody made it in though.
Jeff, is it three rounds or four rounds?
Four rounds.
Okay, thanks.
You bet. Rachel, did you plow through that already?
No, I'm trying to get sound working better.
I skipped the last round of inchworm press-ups because it wasn't making my shoulder very happy. That's a heck of a warm-up. I'm ready to call it a day. Just kidding, though. There's more. Emily, I am so jealous of that storage closet.
You like the shelves?
Yeah.
Thank you.
They look sturdy.
They're very sturdy. I built them last year.
Nice. Where's everybody at in this warm-up? All right. I am going to grab a stool. If you have a stool that you can sit on or a chair that doesn't have arms, something you can stay away from the back of the chair, that's great. I'll demo a way to do this without the chair. We're moving on to strength. And the seated single arm press. So if I'm seated on a stool, I've got both feet firmly planted into the floor. My back is up nice and tall. My ribs are still connected to my pelvis. So I'm not sitting up tall with an arched back. Ribs are glued down to my pelvis. I've got my weight up here in the front rack. If I've got a dumbbell, one head of the dumbbell is resting on my shoulder. If I've got a kettlebell, it's in that front rack in the crook of my elbow. If I've got a can of soup or a water bottle, it's right here in my hand, stacked over my elbow. Then I'm gonna squeeze my shoulder blades back and down to get ready to press. And then press up, straight up into midline. So my bicep is covering my ear at the top, and then back down. So I'm gonna do 5 sets of 10 reps each arm of that. If you don't have a stool, I can come down to the floor kneeling. Still get my ribs glued down to my pelvis. And I'll press from here. So I'm gonna do 5 sets of 10 on one side, but you do 5 sets of 10 on both sides. Thank you. Nice work, friends. I have one set left, but I'm only doing one side at a time, so take your time. Rachel, are you done? Nice work, friends. Way to gut out that last rep, Katie. All right, oh, sorry. Nice. All right, moving on to the second element of strength, overhead extension. You could do this seated. You could do it standing. You could do it kneeling. Let's try for seated, and then we'll make changes as we need. So I'm gonna use the same dumbbell I used for my presses. I'm gonna put it overhead in both hands. So I've got the head of the dumbbell in the diamond of my hands. Arms up overhead. I'm gonna drop it down behind my head, keeping my elbows pointed up at the ceiling, as close to pointed at the ceiling as I can. And then I'm just driving the dumbbell back up till my arms are straight. So this works with a kettlebell, this works with a can of soup. If whatever you've got is just too light for both arms, you can do these one-armed. So you can do one arm at a time. We're gonna do 5 sets of 12 reps. So if I was standing, I just wanna make sure if I'm standing that I'm not arching my back, ribs are glued down to my pelvis.
Wait, how many of these are we supposed to do?
5 sets of 12 reps. It's almost t-shirt weather, so we got to get these arms looking t-shirt ready, you know? Just kidding. If you got arms, you're t-shirt ready. I'm really disappointed. It doesn't look like anybody's using the shake weight.
Does Solcana have any that we can borrow?
We're all out of it. I lost track of how many sets I did. Where's everybody at? Rachel's doing circus tricks.
That kind of feels good. I was just trying to balance my entire body on this small stool.
Heather, is that a small backup dog? Oh, it's a cat. Now you guys had a kitty.
You can never have too many pets.
Yeah.
Koji came back with me from Japan.
Aw. So it looks like everybody's all set with those overhead extensions. Feeling a good pump in your triceps, I hope. Yeah. All right, we are going to move on to the Metcon, the breathe heavy, get sweaty portion. It starts with high knees, which for some of you, depending on your living situation, we may need to change a little bit. So a high knee is like a super weird run in place. So it's high knees. If your living arrangements aren't going to allow for that, you can just step in place with high knees. This is one instance where we're counting moving twice as one rep. So left leg plus right leg is one. Does that make sense? So we're going to do 20 of those to start with. Left leg plus right leg 20 times. Then, after each time we do high knees, we're going to come down to the floor and do toes to object. So in this case, I'm going to use that 10-pound dumbbell that I just used. You could use the leg of a couch. You can use something heavy. Something to grab onto overhead. And I'm going to bring my legs up and over as far as I can go. I can change this up by bending my legs and bringing them up just a little. I can bring my legs up to a 45 degree. I can bring my legs up to a 90 degree. Want to make sure that as you go to lift your legs, you're mashing your low back down into the floor. Lifting your legs is going to cause your low back to try to lift up off the floor. You got to be in charge of that and mash it into the floor. So we're going to do 10 of those. Could I see 5 from everybody?
Hey, Jeff, are we supposed to keep our legs straight or do they have like a natural bend?
They don't have to be like ramrod straight. They'll bend a little. And bent legs is a great modification if a straight leg is just too much for your low back to counteract. Then after our 10 toes to object, we come up to standing and we do 20 air squats. So I stand with my feet roughly hip width apart or where I might land if I jumped. I'm gonna stand up tall. I'm gonna drive my knees out and sit my hips down into that space, trying to get the crease of my hips down below my knees, keeping my back up nice and tall. We'll do 20 of those. Let's do 5 now. All right. So high knees, the reps on those keep increasing. Yay! The toes to object and the air squats stay the same. So we start with 20 high knees, do the toes to object and air squats. Then we do 40 high knees, toes, squats, 60, 80, and 100 high knees. Each time we do high knees, we follow it up with 10 toes to object and 20 air squats. Make sense? So it starts with 20 high knees, 10 toes to object, 20 air squats, and 40 high knees, and so on. 20, 40, 60, 80, 100.
Is there a time cap?
The rest of the day?
Oh, okay. Well, I wasn't sure if it was supposed to be like every 4 minutes or 3 minutes or what, I don't know.
This is for time, as fast as you want to go. So it's 1:45 right now. I'll put 15 minutes on the clock. Any questions before we get rolling?
So your back is like lifting off, like doing a plow, or is staying flat? I didn't hear that.
In the toes to object?
Yeah.
You want to keep your back squished into the floor. Okay. So as you go to lift your legs, your low back is going to want to lift off, but you got to be in charge of it to squish it into the floor. Cool. All right. We are going to get started with 20 high knees in 10 seconds. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, go.
Nice work, friends. We're past 5 minutes. And I just realized I have my shirt on inside out, so. Coming up on 9 minutes. 9 minutes in. My knees are no joke. Down. 80 of these, huh? Nice job, Nick. Nice job, Jana. Seconds. That way, Delta. 10 seconds. 5, 3, 2, 1, time. Nice work, friends. I think maybe I was counting the high knees wrong. I don't know. I didn't get to the set of 100. If you got through all those rounds, you're 100 squats closer to your, well, the gym's weekly goal of 525. So you're that much closer. Let's talk about mobility, which I forgot to look at before we got started. Full upright lunge. So one knee is going to come onto the floor, and then I'm going to push through the hip of the knee that's down. Coming up to upright. If you want to increase some of the tension, take the arm, same arm as the knee you've got down, and bring that back behind your head.
creates a little more fascial tension. I'm gonna switch sides. All right, I'm going to say goodbye to everybody who's watching on the YouTube stream. Thanks for joining. And now I'll chat with you guys.